welcome Isaac, Taylor, and I have to start off with a bit of an apology because our producer told us you were loving that last naked package of Michael's, but you couldn't actually see it, so don't worry, we'll send you a link.
Oh, thank you.
We really, thank you. Yeah. We want to thank you for not showing us.
Listen, I'm proud of my body. I'm sure you're proud of your body. Let's do it in the dark separately.
Sounds like a plan.
Is that a proposition?
Now,
just being proud alone.
Yeah, I got that bit. I understood that bit. Now, I have to say congratulations on 30 years together. You're on the last leg of your world tour, and you're now in Perth. You're looking forward to the show tonight?
Absolutely, yeah. This is the first show of a run of shows. We'll be here throughout the month.
Yeah.
What better way to wrap up a year of touring than
coming to Australia?
Here in Australia.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so we've got a pick here from a show that you just did in Brazil, which is so impressive. Ooh. And honestly, it looks like your fans are some of the most dedicated in the world. Why do you think they've remained so devoted to you?
Well, for one, because we mostly keep our clothes on.
Yeah.
But I think, believe it or not, they don't like that. It's such an anomaly in Brazil. Yeah. I mean, honestly, there's a community. To be serious, there's a community element. I mean, we first broke out now. I mean, most people met us 25 years ago, not 30. We started 5 years or so before we got signed. And of course, and you know, there's a connection. You have a connection. It's not just about a pop song. It's about people joining one another at a show. People make connections with other fans, and all of a sudden, you know, they're coming to three shows on a tour, and they're traveling.
There's a lot of messages in our songs too that I think are about living up to your best purpose in the world, and you know, not feeling alone, and that I think has been something where people have bonded together over songs like Weird or Child at Heart or I Was Born. Yeah. You know, these songs that are really about saying, hey, go out and make the world better with the people around you.
Yeah. And you guys
and go on a cruise.
Yeah. No cruise.
You guys.
Sorry, that's the last
one. Just gonna keep this a last show.
I mean, have you not thought of trying it without the clothes? Because it would be a totally different crowd.
Yeah, no, it would be.
It would be. Yeah.
No, thank you. Continue trying to have a good interview. We appreciate it.
Things we love about you guys. I mean, Hamish and I were working out this afternoon that we've probably interviewed you guys more than we've interviewed anyone else. We love having you on the show, and part of that is that beautiful positivity that you have. But you started out so young, you've stayed so level-headed, and of course, as you would know, we heard that very sad news today of the passing of Aaron Carter. I'm sure that must have come as a shock to all of you.
Well, I mean, obviously he started off as a young kid just like we did, and it's very sad to see someone who passes at an early age. It's a sad thing, sad thing.
And you know, you never know the circumstances, but what you do know is there's a lot of people around him hurting, young children that are his, you know, and you just sort of you reach out to those people and you know. We're all sad together over that.
Yeah.
So how have you all managed to navigate fame so successfully, having started so young?
Well, I mean, first of all, you take one day at a time. I mean, we're certainly not normal, but I don't know what normal is really. And I think figuring out something that you really love and doing it for that reason. Yeah. I mean, for us, one thing that is true is for better or for worse, we've never really done it to be famous. We've done it because, you know, we're musicians, we're songwriters. So you do it for the five people in the front row or for the 5,000. And I think, I will say, I think that helps sort of balance it all out, because some days you feel like you're on the top of the world, some days you're not, but ultimately, you're sort of, it goes back to just the thing that you did at the very beginning. That's the reason.
I think you also see it's extremely hard to do it on your own. If you're a solo artist, it's all the hard things of being in the public eye multiplied by some factor. Yeah. And so doing it together, we always had a close-knit group, obviously three brothers, but then around us, we built great band members and relationships and people who help us kind of see ourselves and know that when things get hard, when days are long, when you're thousands of miles away from your family, like you still have a little family that you're traveling with.
Always have someone close to you that can tell you you're an idiot.
That's the rule. Mentioning your family, we all know you've got 15 children between you. Is that sort of why You're touring again? Yeah. Is it to get a break from all the kids? Is that...
Well, as you guys know, we've never really stopped touring. Yeah. We have taken breaks, and yes, our wives are saying, please leave us.
Every time you come home, something weird happens 9 months later. No,
it's definitely a full tour bus and a full house. For everybody, and we do not count them collectively. We
exactly.
Try to
I'm only responsible
this.
For screwing up three kids' lives. Yeah. These guys have a whole other problem.
It's definitely, I mean, family is definitely a huge strength. I think people, especially in our industry, it is very, very hard to balance it. Mm-hmm. So we've all been, we've hit the jackpot. We all married incredible women that joined us in this crazy journey and also, you know, helped. And are the backbone of how we can have amazing families.
I make the
families.
Joke the key is actually imbalance. Because we have a bunch of kids, so we've just gone kind of the inverse of rock and roll. We've been like, listen, we're going to be really extreme and just have a bunch of kids.
You know, it is, you know, on a serious note, though, like having kids and talking about that kind of legacy of being a band for 30 years and how do you stay normal?
Guys.
I mean, the kids are such an amazing factor in that because they inspire you. And
guys, we're going to have to give you the rap, guys, because we're totally out of time. Would you please thank the wonderful Hanson?